afford anything but a table model, but it's got a nice-sized screen, and it's easy to operate.
All you have to do is turn that dial, and you have all the company you want right there on the screen. Drama, comedy, life's parade at your fingertips.
Last night, I dreamt I went to Manderley again. It seemed to me I stood by the iron gate leading to the drive. And for a while, I could not enter, for the way was barred to me. Then, like all dreamers, I was possessed of a sudden with supernatural powers and passed like a spirit through the barrier before me.
I've seen you before. I know your face.
Get out, or shall I call my servant?
You're Norma Desmond. Used to be in silent pictures. Used to be big.
I am big. It's the pictures that got small.
Gilda, are you decent?
Me? Sure, I'm decent.
You know you don't have to act with me, Steve. You don't have to say anything and you don't have to do anything. Not a thing. Oh, maybe just whistle. You know how to whistle, don't you, Steve? You just put your lips together and blow.
We're going to dance the Peckerwood Wiggle, or whatever you call it, and I want you to lead the figure.
Oh, I'd be glad to, Madge.
Cute. I'd like to kiss you, but I just washed my hair. Bye.
Oh, Cuba, that's not a bad idea.
Imagine me on this beach here in my green bathing suit. Yipe. I almost fought a white one the other day, but it wasn't quite extreme enough. I mean, don't get me wrong. If I really went in for the extreme, I would have bought a French one. Run for your lives, girls, a fleet scent. Oh, Uncle Lon, am I excited? Yipe!
Well?
I want to be alone.
Where have you been? I suppose I can cancel the Vienna contract?
I just want to be alone.
You're going to be very much alone, my dear madame. This is the end.
You were wonderful tonight.
I'm always wonderful at math.
Yes, but tonight you were especially good.
Well, when I'm good, I'm very good. But when I'm bad, I'm better.
Lena, you're a beautiful woman. Audiences think you've got a voice to match. The studio's got to keep their stars from looking ridiculous at any cost.
No one's got that much money.
What's wrong with the way I talk? What's the big idea? Am I dumb or something?
No. No, it's just that Don's had so much more experience.
Next time, write me out a speech. I could memorize it.
Sure. Why don't you go out now and recite the Gettysburg Address?
Well, what do you know about it? You piano player, are you anybody?
One career all females have in common, whether we like it or not, being a woman. Sooner or later, we've got to work at it, no matter how many other careers we've had or wanted. And in the last analysis, nothing's any good unless you can look up just before dinner or turn around in bed, and there he is. Without that, you're not a woman.
I afraid? Why should I be?
Oh, of course not. You're the greatest actor in the world. Everybody knows that, including you.
Don't be a prima donna.
Whenever there's a chance to take the spotlight away from me, it's becoming ridiculous the way you grab attention. Whenever I start to tell a story, you finish it. If I go on a diet, you lose the weight. If I have a cold, you cough. And if we should ever have a baby, I'm not so sure I'd be the mother.
I'm satisfied to be the father.
There's an intelligent way to approach marriage.
Intelligence. Nothing has caused the human race so much trouble as intelligence. Modern marriage.
Now, we've progressed emotionally.
Baloney. Once it was see somebody, get excited, get married. Now it's read a lot of books, fence with a lot of four-syllable words, psychoanalyze each other until you can't tell the difference between a petting party and a civil service exam.
You don't know what it's like to watch somebody you love just crumble away bit by bit, day by day, in front of your eyes. And stand there, helpless. Love isn't enough.
Not that I care, but where is your husband?
Why, he's dead.
I'll bet he's just using that as an excuse.
I was with him till the very end.
No wonder he passed away.
I held him in my arms and kissed him.
Oh, I see. Then it was murder. Will you marry me? Did he leave you any money? Answer the second question first.
He left me his entire fortune.
Is that so? Can't you see what I'm trying to tell you? I love you.
Oh, Your Excellency.
Oh, we'll arrange it somehow. Whatever way we can. We'll have such wonderful times together. Just the two of us.
You'll be the happiest person in the world.
This big and happiest.
Oh, Angel, if I can only tell you how much I love you. I can only tell you all.
Tell Mama. Tell Mama all.
One thing. Me.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing you can't fix.
50 million television sets in America, and now with the coaxial cable.
I had onions at lunch. I had garlic dressing at dinner. But he'll never know. Because I stay kissing sweet, the new dazzle dent way.
And now that I have your attention, I want to warn all you girls and women of New York about an evil, dangerous, perfectly dreadful married man who lives downstairs in my building.
His name is Sherman, Richard Sherman.
So I said, you coming home for supper? So he says, I'll write you a letter. So I said, you coming home after? So he says, I'll put an ad in the New York Times price little column and let you know. So I says, don't get too sassy, Mr. Attinger. So he says, and don't you be looking at me so cockeyed, because I don't want to have to shake your head up to straighten them out. So I threw it.
Threw what?
The pot. So he left mad.
Would they hang you for a thing like that?
Oh, but not if you do it right and you're smart, Frank. You'll think of a way. Plenty of men have.
He never did anything to me.
But, darling, can't you see how happy you and I would be together here without him?
Do you love me, Cora?
That's why you've got to help me. It's because I do love you.
Yes, you do. You couldn't get me to say yes to a thing like this if you didn't.
I loved you, Walter, and I hated him. But I wasn't going to do anything about it, not until I met you. You planned the whole thing. I only wanted him dead.
And I'm the one that fixed it so he was dead. Is that what you're telling me?
And nobody's pulling out. We went into this together and we're coming out at the end together. It's straight down the line for both of us. Remember?
Do you love me?
Yes, I do.
I can't. Leslie, what is it?
With all my heart, I still love the man I killed.
Heidenberg! Top of the world!
And personally, I think a chicken is as good a reason for murder as a blonde, a mattress full of dollar bills, or any of the customary, unimaginative reasons.
Now, you don't really approve of murder, Rupert, if I may.
You may, and I do. Think of the problems it would solve. Unemployment, poverty, standing in line for theater tickets.